Hello children, welcome to online classes. Now I am going to explain some important MCQ from aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids and amines. Which one of the following reagents react with both acetaldehyde and acetone? With both of them, see, tollens reagent, Skips reagent and failings solution. These three are used to distinguish aldehydes and ketones. That's why these three can react with only acetaldehyde, not with acetone. So Grignard's reagent can react with both acetaldehyde and acetone. When ethanol is heated with failings solution, it gives a precipitate of cuprous oxide, which is insoluble in water and red colored one. So it gives red color precipitate of Cu2O. Answer should be C. Which of the following has more number of acidic hydrogens? Acidic hydrogen. Hydrogen which is attached to alpha carbon with respect to electron withdrawing group is called acidic hydrogen. So which one has more number of alpha hydrogens with respect to ketone or aldehyde? 1, 1, 1, 1, all are ketones given. So we have to count the number of alpha hydrogens. If you take hexane 3-1, this is hexane 3-1, 2, 2, both the sides alpha carbons are there. Here only 4 alpha hydrogens are present. Hexane 2,4 dione at second position and fourth position, CO is there. This is hexane 2,4 dione. So we count the number of alpha hydrogens, CH3, 3, CH2, 2, here CH2. So 3 plus 2 plus 2, 4, 7, 7 alpha hydrogens in this case. Hexane 2,5 dione. Hexane 2,5 at second position and fifth position, double bonds, C double bond O. So now you count 3 here, 2, 2, 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 7, 3, 10, 10 alpha hydrogens in option C. Hexane 2,3 dione. This is hexane 2,3 dione. So count the number of alpha hydrogens, 3 and 2, 5. So which one has highest number of acidic hydrogens? Option C. IUPAC name of croton aldehyde. So we must know what is croton aldehyde. CH3, CH double bond, CH. CHO. This is obtained during the aldol condensation of acetaldehyde in the presence of dilute base. 1, 2, 3, 4. Numbering from right to left. So, bute at second position in. One all you need not mention, that is CHO, carbon of CHO gets one only. Bute 2 in all. Where is that option? B. The reagent used for the separation of acetaldehyde from acetophenone. So you have to check the structure. CH3, COH and acetophenone. methyl phenyl ketone is acetophenone. So both will give iodoform test. Both will give iodoform test. So we cannot separate. Both will react with hydroxyl amine. We cannot separate. Let us take sodium bisulfite. Because of higher steric hindrance around carbonyl carbon, acetophenone cannot react with sodium bisulfite, whereas acetaldehyde only can react. So one reacts with sodium bisulfite, another one cannot react. That's why correct answer is A. Among the following, the strongest base. Here aniline. Paranitroaniline. Option B is paranitroaniline. Option C is metanitroaniline. At meta position NO2 group. Option D is phenyl hydrazine. Phenyl hydrazine. Aliphatic amines are more basic when compared with aromatic amine. The reason, lone pair of the nitrogen is involved in the conjugation with pi bonds of benzene ring. So availability of lone pair in aniline is less. So whereas in aliphatic amines, lone pair is not involved in the conjugation. And moreover, alkyl group is electron donating group. So electron density is more in aliphatic amines. So aliphatic amines are more basic than aromatic amines. That's why among all these, the last one, D option only, aliphatic amine. This is aliphatic amine. One phenyl methanamine, its name. So answer is D. IUPAC name again. Let us select the main carbon chain here. CHO, CH2. 1, 2. The C6H5 is the substituent. C6H5, CH2, CHO. First carbon, second carbon. So C6H5 is called phenyl. Phenyl ethanol. 2 phenyl ethanol. Eth root word, an. Benzaldehyde cannot be prepared from. So we can prepare benzaldehyde by Rosenmund's reduction. You take benzoyl chloride plus hydrogen in the presence of palladium barium sulfate. Rosenmund's reduction we can get. Benzaldehyde can be prepared by Gaterman-Koch formulation. Benzene plus CO plus HCl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. That also possible. Friedel-Crafts acylation. In Friedel-Crafts acylation, benzene is reacted with acid halide like acid chloride in the presence of AlCl3. That's why in place of H of benzene, we can get acyl group. This is acyl group. So we can get ketone. We can't get aldehyde. So correct answer is Friedel-Crafts acylation. It gives only ketone, aromatic ketone. The product obtained, dry distillation of calcium formate. You write the calcium formate. This is calcium formate. On heating, dry distillation, HCO combines with another H. HCOH plus the other product is CaO and CO2. CaCO3, formaldehyde. The product obtained is nothing but formaldehyde. Methyl alcohol, methanol, on oxidation gives controlled oxidation. So what happens? CH3 COH H H. This is methyl alcohol. sorry, methyl alcohol, not ethyl. This is methyl alcohol. On controlled oxidation, remove H2O, HCH, between oxygen and carbon, double bond is created. Formaldehyde. Further, if it is subjected to oxidation with strong oxidizing agent, we can get formic acid, after that CO2 and H2O. So answer is formaldehyde. Oxidation of 2-propanol with acidified sodium dichromate yields 2-propanol CH3 CHOH CH3. This is propane 2-ol. On oxidation, it gives 2 hydrogens are removed as H2O. We can get acetone, ketone. So, ketone won't undergo oxidation under normal conditions. So, the final product obtained is nothing but propanone. 3-pentanone and 2-pentanone are metamers. The reason, CH3CH2CO CH2CH3. This is 3-pentanone. With respect to 3-pentanone, you check the alkyl groups, ethyl, ethyl. So both the sides ethyls. That's why if you write the common name, diethyl ketone is the common name. Now you change the alkyl groups. 2-pentanone you take, CH3CO CH2CH2CH3. You keep the CO in the same way, methyl one side and propyl other side. So with respect to divalent functional group, these two are obtained due to change in the nature of alkyl groups. So its name, common name, methyl propyl ketone. Two compounds with same molecular formula but different alkyl groups attached to polyvalent functional group are called metamers. So 2-pentanone, 3-pentanone are metamers. If you check the IUPAC name, you may get confusion as position isomers, but they are considered metamers. Ketone exhibits chain isomerism. You see this one, this is ketone. These two are having same molecular formula, both are chain isomers because main carbon chain only different. So ketones exhibit chain isomerism, position isomerism, functional group isomerism. Aldehydes and ketones both are functional group isomers. So whenever at least two are correct answers, when fourth option is all, no need to check third one. Answer is D, all of these. IUPAC name. First, you select the longest carbon chain including functional group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bromine is substituent and CH3 also another substituent. So, 3-bromo, bromine and methyl both are there in the prefix. Bromine is written first. So 3-bromo, 2-methyl, main carbon chain has 5 carbons. So pentanol. Where is that option? C. The compound which forms acetaldehyde when heated with dilute sodium hydroxide. Compound which forms acetaldehyde when heated with dilute sodium hydroxide. You keep on checking the options. Let us take 1,1 dichloroethane, CH3 CH Cl Cl. This is 1,1 dichloroethane heated with dilute NaOH. During the heating with dilute NaOH, what happens? Nucleophilic substitution takes place. 2 Cl group, chlorines are replaced with two OH groups. Gem diol is obtained. This is gem diol. Gem diols, we know, highly unstable since two OH groups are on the same carbon. That's why what happens? H2O molecule is eliminated immediately from both OH groups. So due to elimination of H2O, dehydration, CH3COH. So between oxygen and carbon, pi bond is created. This is nothing but acetaldehyde. So first option only giving correct answer, 1,1-dichloroethane. If this is not correct answer, you should go for B. You have to check B option next to C option. Number of structural isomeric aldehydes and ketones possible for the molecular formula C5H10O. So they are asking only aldehydes and ketones. Let us take aldehydes. No pi bond here, no unsaturated, no pi bond between two carbons. Only the pi bond should be between C and O. That's why aldehydes and ketones only they are asking. First, pentanol. You make one branch at second position, 2-methylpentanol. You keep the branch at third carbon, 3-methylpentanol, and you make it propanol, but you keep 2-methyl branches at second position, 2,2-dimethylpropanol. 4 aldehydes we got. Coming to the ketones, pentanone 2, pentanone 3, and you make the branch from pentanone 2. One, two, three. 3-methylbutanone 2. So total number of aldehydes. These are all are having aldehyde and keto groups. 4 aldehydes and 3 ketones. Total 7. A is the correct answer. Acetophenone is obtained by the reaction between acetyl chloride. This is Rosenman's reduction. No, sorry. Friedel-Crafts oscillation. Benzene plus acetyl chloride. CH3COCl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. Electrophilic substitution. So, COCH3. When COCH3 is directly attached to the benzene ring, that is nothing but acetophenone. So the correct answer is, with which one acetyl chloride reacts to give acetophenone? So answer is B, benzene. Which of the following compounds does not undergo Kenny-Jarosz reaction? To undergo Kenny-Jarosz reaction, alpha hydrogen should not be there. But which of the following compound does not undergo Kenny-Jarosz means it has alpha hydrogen. First you check the option A, CH3CHO. This is ethanol. CHO carbon functional group, and next carbon, CH3 carbon, is alpha carbon. It has 3 alpha hydrogen. That's why ethanol undergoes aldol condensation but not Kenny-Jarosz reaction. So answer is ethanol. Methyl ketones are usually identified by haloform test. Haloform, maybe iodoform, chloroform, bromoform. So methyl ketones, CH3CO. This side anything may be there. So this is methyl group. Ketone containing methyl group called methyl ketones. When they are reacted with iodine in the presence of base, the alpha methyl group is converted into iodoform. So answer is iodoform. Acetylene on reaction with dilute H2SO4, sulfuric acid undergoes hydration. This is hydration reaction. Acetylene undergoes hydration when passed into the aqueous solution of 1% mercuric sulfate and 46% sulfuric acid. It gives X. So first of all, we can take what is X. Acetylene, it undergoes hydration in the presence of acidified mercuric ions. H goes to one carbon, OH goes to another carbon after breaking one pi bond. So CH2, left side carbon becomes CH2 double bond, right side carbon is taking OH. This is nothing but enol. Enol form is unstable, we know. So automatically it undergoes tautomerization. During the tautomerization, H from OH shifted onto alpha carbon. Pi bond is shifted from CC to CO. So CH2 becomes CH3. CC single bond. Between carbon and oxygen, double bond created. This aldehyde, this is X. X undergoes oxidation. Aldehyde easily undergoes oxidation due to insertion of oxygen between C and H. So the product formed here is CH3COOH. Acetic acid is the product. Answer is A. Coming to some problems from carboxylic acids and amines. Decarboxylation of sodium salt of carboxylic acid with soda lime. NaOH and CaO nothing but soda lime. So decarboxylation, let it be sodium carboxylic, sodium salt of carboxylic acid, RCOONa. This is sodium salt of carboxylic acid. On decarboxylation by using soda lime, alkyl group is separated, combines with hydrogen forming RH. RH is nothing but alkane. Alkane plus NaNa and CO3. Na2CO3 is the byproduct. So answer is alkane. Which of the following on hydrolysis forms acetic acid? So let us check the option A, next option B, next option C, and then D. First you check the option A, CH3CN. Any cyanide on hydrolysis in the presence of acid, it undergoes hydrolysis, it gives carboxylic acid. So during the hydrolysis of any cyanide, we can get carboxylic acid along with ammonia gas. So hydrolysis is carried out in the presence of acid. That's why CH3C, you break the triple bond and the carbon, triply bonded carbon, now converted into carboxylic acid, double bond O and single bond OH along with ammonia gas. So answer, this only CH3CN only giving acetic acid. Now no need to check the option B, option C. Which acid is strongest? Acidic strength, relative acidic strength comparison increases when the stability of conjugate base carboxylate ion is increased. That will be increased by electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group can decrease the electron negatively charge on carboxylate. So electron withdrawing group increases relative acidic strength, electron donating group decreases acidic strength. So in this case, one is acetic acid. In place of one of the three hydrogens, chlorine is introduced. So this is more acidic. when compared with C, B is more acidic. In the case of A, there are two chlorines, there are two electron withdrawing groups, that's why A is again more acidic. Then in the case of D, three electron withdrawing groups are there, so this is the order. So D is the strongest acid. Which one of the following is weakest acid? Just now I explained. Weakest acid, CH3COOH, bromoacetic acid, chloroacetic acid, fluoroacetic acid. Here, if B, C, D, these three are having minus I groups, electron withdrawing groups. Strongest withdrawing group is fluorine. That's why D is the strongest acid. After that, chlorine is the next strongest. After that, C. After that, B. But A option, there is no electron withdrawing group. That's why strongest acid is D, weakest acid is A. They are asking weakest acid. That's why option is A. Acetic acid on heating with P2O5. P2O5 is phosphorus pentoxide. Phosphorus pentoxide, we know, dehydrating agent, powerful dehydrating agent. So H2O molecule is separated. Let us write acetic acid. Two molecules, from two molecules of acetic acid, P2O5 can remove H2O on heating with P2O5. Dehydration takes place. Dehydration, from one acetic acid OH is removed, from other acetic acid H is removed. So CH3CO, OCOCH3, this is nothing but acetic anhydride. So this same compound can be written as CH3CO is common. CH3CO taken twice, O. O is common for both aceto groups. That's why answer is C, acetic anhydride. Correct answer is C. Lower carboxylic acids are soluble in water. The one organic compound which is capable to form intermolecular hydrogen bond with water molecules is soluble in water. So, what type of organic compounds are soluble which are having acidic hydrogen? If hydrogen attached to O, hydrogen attached to N, the organic compounds containing this type of bonds, OH bond or NH bond, can form hydrogen bond with water molecule. That's why they are soluble in water. So in lower carboxylic acids, the alkyl group hydrophobic end is less, or COOH, they can form hydrogen bond with water molecules. That's why they are soluble. So answer is, as they are capable to form hydrogen bonding, they are soluble in water. Correct answer is B. Alkyl magnesium halide or MgX on reaction with carbon dioxide, for convenient we can write like this, R comes out in the form of R minus nucleophile, attacks at electrophilic carbon. Carbon is positively charged carbon. So nucleophilic attack, R CO O minus. This O minus can combine with cation MgX plus. This is adduct, salt-like adduct. After this, acidification in the presence of an acid, O minus takes H plus, forming RCOOH. This is one of the best methods for the preparation of carboxylic acids. So, correct answer is D. Carboxylic acids react with dash due to acidic nature. Since they are acidic in nature, they are strong acidic. After losing H+, carboxylic acid will become stable carboxylate conjugate base. This is stable due to conjugation. So, carboxylic acid is stronger acid. Because of this acidic nature, it reacts with sodium. It reacts with sodium hydroxide. Even it reacts with weak base sodium bicarbonate or sodium carbonate also. So, carboxylic acids can react with these three because of acidic nature. So, the correct answer is D. So, whenever all is there, you have to take care. Correct answer is D. Which of the following PKB value indicates highest basic nature? So relative basic strength or basicity increases when KB value increases. Increases when PKB value decreases. So basic strength and KB running parallel to each other. Basic strength and PKB anti-parallel to each other. So PKB lowest means basic strength is highest. Among these three, 3.29, 3.40, 3.38, 4.70. One with lowest PKB is the highest basic. Answer is A. Amine plus RCOCl. Here, this is nucleophilic acyl substitution reaction. Or NH2, because of the lone pair, it attacks at electrophilic carbon, acylic carbon. It attacks at C. Cl minus will go. That Cl minus can take H plus from N. So we can get RCO to this NH, R is attached. This is nothing but amide. CONH bond is there, amide, but substituent alkyl group. So N alkyl alkanamide. The correct answer is A. Aniline reacts with bromine water. Bromine water. Bromine in the presence of water to give. So in aniline, NH2 is present. That NH2 is very, very strong donating group, ring activating group, where this is powerful ring activating group. It activates the benzene ring at ortho and para positions. So that's why in the presence of water, bromine, in the presence of water polar solvent, three places are replaced with bromine. So tribromination takes place. A white precipitate of 2,4,6 tribromoaniline is obtained. Where is the correct 2,4,6 tribromoaniline? C is the correct answer. Aniline reacts with the concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid at 288 Kelvin to give. So concentrated nitric acid and H2SO4 nothing but nitration mixture. In the presence of electron donating group NH2, during the nitration process, we can expect, since this is ortho para directing group, we can expect ortho nitroaniline and para nitroaniline. Ortho nitroaniline, para nitroaniline, but in addition to these two, even meta nitroaniline also obtained at meta position also. This is surprising one. So this is due to the formation of anilinium ion. Because of strong acidic mixture, NH2, since it is Lewis base, it takes H plus from acidic mixture and forms NH3 plus. NH3 plus is withdrawing group and acts as meta directing group. That is the reason we can get the mixture of 3 ortho nitroaniline, para nitroaniline and meta nitroaniline. So correct answer. Now ortho nitro, meta nitro, para nitro. That's why answer is D. NH2 undergoes acylation in the presence of pyridine. NH2 undergoes acylation at NH. In place of 1H, COCH3 is attached. So this is X. X on nitric on nitration, this is a relatively weak donating group. This is a weak ring activating group. That's why nitration occurs at ortho position or at para position. Para position is main one. So para nitro acetonylide. COCH3. After the formation of para nitro, subjected to hydrolysis. During the hydrolysis, what happens? CN bond is undergoing hydrolysis. N takes H, CO takes OH. So we can get NH2 back, and at para position NO2 remains present. So para nitro aniline. Which of the following represents the correct order of the acidic strength? Alcohols, when compared with alcohols, water is more acidic. Phenols are more acidic when compared with water. Then aliphatic carboxylic acids. After that, aromatic carboxylic acid. This is the order of acidic strength. But one exception is there. Aromatic carboxylic acid, benzoic acid, is more acidic when compared with aliphatic, since phenyl group is electron withdrawing group. But exception is there. Among aliphatic carboxylic acid, formic acid is more acidic even than benzoic acid. That you have to observe. So among all these, acetic acid, benzoic acid, formic acid, and phenol given, phenol is the least acidic, we know. So we can expect A and B options. But in this case, formic acid highest acidic, acetic acid highest acidic. So in between these two options, B is correct answer, because formic acid obviously more acidic than acetic acid. That's why correct answer is B. Which among the following is the strongest acid? NO2 is electron withdrawing group. Orthonitrobenzoic acid, paranitrobenzoic acid, metanitro, and this is donating group. CH3 is donating group. That's why no doubt D is the least acidic. Among these three, NO2 at ortho position, NO2 at meta and para, because of ortho effect, the acidic strength of benzoic acid increased. Any group, maybe withdrawing, maybe donating, any group present at ortho position can increase acidic strength of benzoic acid. That's why correct answer is A. How many isomeric amines are possible for the molecular formula C3H9N? You start writing the amines. First you write it as main primary amine, CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2, propane 1 amine. Next, you change the position of NH2, CH3, CH, NH2, CH3, propane 2 amine, and you can't get primary amine by changing the position. Now, you make it 2 degree amine, CH3, CH2, NH, CH3, and you make it 3 degree amine, attach 3 methyl groups to the same nitrogen, 3 degree amine. So 2 are 1 degree amines, 1 is 2 degree amine, 1 is 3 degree amine. Total number of isomers 4 with the formula C3H9N. The amide which does not undergo Hoffmann's bromide degradation. Hoffmann bromide degradation, we know, RCONH2. When it is reacted with bromine in the presence of KOH, CO part is removed and RNH2 is obtained. Acetamide can give methylamine. Benzamide can give aniline, but formamide, if you take HCOH, it cannot give amine. So answer is C. The order of basic strength for the following amines. We know in vapor state, 3 degree amines are more basic, then 2 degree, then 1 degree, then ammonia. Moreover, aliphatic amine is more basic than aromatic amine C6H5NH2. So availability of the lone pair at nitrogen is less in aniline, that's why aniline is less basic. So among all these four options, in which option aniline is at the bottom? A and B. So in between A and B, which is correct answer? So this, in the case of B, dimethylamine methylamine, so 2 degree, 1 degree after that phenylamine. B is the correct answer. So like this, you have to do as many questions as possible, especially from organic chemistry. Okay, children, all the best.